the farmer. One of the world's oldest, noblest professions. Hardly anything embodies the American spirit more than a farmer. They get up early at the crack of dawn, work long hours, provide for their family and others, and take matters into their own hands when something doesn't go as planned. Agriculture is a vital part of Delaware's economy, with over 2,300 family farms cultivating nearly 40% of the state's land mass. Farming is arguably Delaware's most important industry. Like every other business and industry in today's world, farmers have been hit hard by the increasingly poor economy. To gain a better understanding of what farmers and those in agriculture are experiencing, our caucus wanted to speak directly to those in the industry. We met up with Jeff Corman, Chris McGee, and Mark Briggs to hear how the economy and recession are impacting their operations.
Jeff Corman, the owner-operator of Allen Corman & Son Incorporated and Corman Sprang. This business has existed since 1946 through, I guess I'm the fourth owner now. You have to be 16 to solo. I soloed on my 16th birthday. Got my private license on my 17th birthday, my commercial license on my 18th birthday, which you have to be 18 to get your commercial, and I started spraying about 2 weeks after that. The biggest hurdle that we're facing is fuel prices, the uncertainty of fuel prices, labor shortage, the increase in labor cost to be able to obtain the people that you need, and getting people to show up. And you know, we're locked under a three-year contract. We have no escalation for fuel, so you just gotta eat it.
On the day of filming the interview, Jeff explained fuel cost him $5.50 per gallon, which was lower than the $7 average a couple months ago, but much higher than the average 2 years ago of $2.50. On Friday, October 14th, while this video was being edited, Jeff said he was paying $5.65 per gallon.
You can't raise your price enough to recapture the fuel, the increased cost in labor, and the increased price in parts. We ordered an air conditioning system for an airplane, and it, 20 weeks out? That's crazy. 20 weeks to get something that you used to be able to get in 3 days. I tell you what we just ran into was a shortage in oil filters and tires. And yes, we'll get them, but it's gonna be next spring before we get them. Right. Just fortunately, our mechanic was smart enough to order them now.
After meeting with Jeff, we headed down to Frankfort and met with Chris to discuss how the economic climate was impacting him and farmers in general.
Christopher McGee, I'm the owner of C. McGee Farms in Frankfort, Delaware. My family started in 1865. We were traditionally loggers, and we got into farming to feed the mules that hauled the lumber to the mill. And then after the World War II, we didn't have any more labor. So my grandfather and my father farmed full-time after that. So I've been farming since I was 12. In 2016, my wife and I bought our first farm, and here we are now. It's really hurt our bottom line because, you know, farmers plan for years in advance. Just the other day, the seed salesman called and said, "Hey, Chris, it's going to be $50 more a bag." Well, that's almost a 25% increase in 1 year. And it's really hard on our aspect because we can't ask for any more money. We can try to market our grain, but we're really on what the country as a whole. Today we're getting $7 corn. We're probably really close to a break-even period there with the diesel fuel, the additional inputs. It's been really hard to, you know, try to turn a profit.
At the time of the interview, Chris noted that they were paying close to $5 per gallon for fuel, which is much higher than before.
Before it all started, we were close to $3. And a lot of that changed in 6 to 8 months. And as being a, you know, I farm with my parents, but I'm also my own entity, trying to plan for 1 year to the other is very hard when prices are so volatile. You know, we'll plan now for what we're doing next year. Well, you could plan for nitrogen to be, $100 a ton. When the economic downturn happened, it went up 225% in less than 8 months. We just have to grit our teeth, take it to the chin, and just try to feed all of America. I mean, people don't understand, you know, one farmer in the United States feeds 33 people. That's a pretty big family that I have to, you know, feed every single day. I'm a man of my word. If I went to you and said, hey, I'm going to rent that farm for $175 an acre, I'm going to honor that. Now, if corn prices go to $4, I still have to pay what I agreed upon. And that's really hard with the volatility of the markets. Wheat prices the other day went up 50 cents, and then 3 days later, they fell a dollar. Never in our life have we ever seen such volatility since the economic downturn. Nothing makes any sense anymore.
Our final stop was in Georgetown to meet with Mark Briggs, another local farmer who, too, is experiencing the hardships of the recession and economic downturn. He also raises chickens and discussed how the current environment is affecting his business.
Mark Briggs, Lucky Star Farms. I went out on my own base or combined farms in 2008 and established Lucky Star Farms. Basically, all the input costs have increased tremendously, whether it's on the poultry side of my operation. We've seen parts prices raise 50% to 75%. We've seen, you know, fuel costs go up, which that's a major operating cost with us with as many poultry houses as we have.
September 2022 inflation numbers show gasoline and diesel are up 18.2% from a year ago, and energy in general is nearly 20% higher. These steep increases have cut deep into Mark's operational costs.
We've seen electric utility costs go up, and basically when we're under contract, you know, our price we get paid per thousand doesn't increase, but these costs do. Usual, most times, summertime electric bill, we run between $2,700 to $2,800 at a three-house farm of mine right down this road here. We just received electric bill for the past month, which was $4,230.
Mark explained that labor costs and government-mandated wage increases made it nearly impossible for farmers and small business owners like himself to compete with larger corporations.
This time last year, when we run an ad for help, we get 20, 25 applicants. Now, I don't even get one because I run it weekly, you know, weekly runs in the guide, and I haven't had a response in, I wouldn't say, the last 3 or 4 months. And like I said, basically we've had to do things ourselves, you know, basically just count on our own. And like I said, I know a lot of farmers who have tried to get help, and they've been unsuccessful because, like I said, they can't afford to pay those kind of, you know, wages. No, it's not been rosy.
Additionally, supply chain issues have been a major hurdle for Mark to overcome.
We had that red truck that's sitting out here that we were hauling grain, and one day she just shut off going down the road. I took her over to a local dealer, they pulled her in there, and they told me that after $10,000 spending on her and still haven't fixed her, that the ECM, the electronic control modules, are going bad. And they basically told me that it would be 6 months before I could get one. So we sent that ECM that was in that truck. So you talk about supply, how it affects people. We had that ECM taken out of that truck, and we sent it off to Canada ourselves. And these people rebuild ECMs for trucks, and we done it ourselves because they couldn't get a new one over there to look, because it'd be 6 months. And the truck sat there for over a month. Everything that we're seeing, though, just like with parts, you know, you're paying for that supply chain gap. Where you used to buy something for $100 last year, now it's $150, $175. You know, we're seeing it every time, you know, and that they're just adding the cost on, because, like I said, these people are now having to pay the $15, $20 an hour wage, and it's getting passed on to the consumer.
In these bleak economic times, it would be easy to give up and admit defeat. Yet, these three men, as well as all farmers in Delaware and across the nation, persevere because it's in their nature. Quitting is not in their vocabulary. The Delaware Senate Republican Caucus appreciates what everyone in the agriculture industry does to bring food to our tables. Thank you, farmers, for all you do.